CBS has worked personally with Donald Trump before he was running for president. Come on in, Lisa Gibbons, author of the new book, Fierce Optimism, and Celebrity Apprentice winner. Well, you know Donald Trump personally, and the big question a lot of people are asking, is he the person that we see on the screen running for president?
When you say I know him personally, and thanks for having me on, I know him in the context of being on the reality show with him and having interviewed him a handful of times. So that's my window on Donald Trump. And you know, that environment's intimidating. So I said, okay, how do I show up and be me in that environment so that I could get to that pathway to winning? And I said, I'm going to see Donald Trump as a dad because his family is so extraordinary. And so I saw him as more of a paternal figure in that context for that show.
Okay. So have you been to any degree surprised at all then with Donald Trump, the candidate?
You know, look, I think what the rest of America thinks, I think that this entire campaign season has been surprising. But Trump is that man, isn't he? He is unfiltered, and he's bold, and he does not shy away from controversy. So those things we knew going into it.
Yeah, I think we did. And here's an interesting thing. I think that ties what the Donald Trump phenomena, if you will, in your book. I think the timing is for both are perfect. The timing for the sort of anger in America and sort of the feeling that we're a rudderless ship as a country. Helps Donald Trump, the outsiders, and Bernie Sanders, but also from the individual's point of view, I think that's where your book, Fierce Optimism, I would think that's where it comes in handy.
Well, look, all the candidates, all leaders, their job is to inspire us to believe that whether it's the economy, whether trust is collapsing, whether you're worried about security, that we're going to get through it. And that's an optimistic frame, is that you're going to rebound and recover. It's really just an emotional competence of knowing that no matter what happens, these are temporary things. But the permanent thing is our mindset. It's how we feel about the things that happen to us and how we respond to those things.
So
that's forever.
Is that the crux of your book then? Is that because you're talking about what leaders are supposed to do. What are we as individuals supposed to do to take control of our own optimism and our own futures?
Well, you know, as individuals, we have setbacks, right? We have disappointments and we have heartaches. And you know, what I write about in the book are the seven secrets are really core values. And they're the values that I grew up with, that I go back to time and time again to reset. What do I want to be about? How am I going to get it right with my kids? How am I going to get the promotion? How am I going to nail that presentation? All the things that we're faced with, if we let our neural pathways be ignited by optimism, then we're going to problem solve more effectively. So the book is about how to use loyalty in that way, how to use empathy, how to use your resilience, how to use your focus to get the things that you want.
So these are essentially tools that we all possess to a certain degree, but unleashing them in a way that perhaps people don't know they can unleash them.
You know, and it's where do you choose, you know, who do you choose to lock horns with? When I talked about focus, I mentioned a story of when I was a young reporter and the news director, as shocking as this sounds, actually said to me, you know, honey, if you just wear your sweaters a little tighter, I think you just might make it in this business.
Yeah.
Well, when I was role playing being a reporter with my Barbie dolls, I'm sure no one talked to Barbie that way, but I chose to focus on what I wanted. I wanted to get out of there. I wanted to get on with it. So I made him irrelevant, and I kept my eye on the prize. And I think that's why people were surprised when they said, wow, nice girls winning Celebrity Apprentice, how does that work? Well, if you can really drop drama in your life and in your business, then you're going to be able to focus more on, you know, it's a physics law. We get what we focus on.
How do you think, though, we got here? I mean, real, you know, it feels like this is one thing that's universal in America. This deep, dark aura of pessimism has all of a sudden ascended over this country. You know, and again, I understand your book and how it could be a guide to getting through this for the individual, but it's amazing to me that the most optimistic country in the world for a long time, when Tocqueville came here, he was shocked. Anyone thought they could be anything, how that faded away.
You know, and maybe it's just recessed a bit, faded, maybe it's fuzzy, but I think that's who we are and how we need to identify.
Fierce Optimism, Lisa Gibbons. Fantastic stuff. Really appreciate it. More Varney.